I can say that it's an extraordinary feeling. You are in a totally different environment. On one hand, you have weightlessness. You have zero gravity in the spaceship, so you are floating free in the cabin. And it takes a few hours to get accustomed to that. The ascent to space, to low Earth orbit, takes only about 8.5 or 9 minutes. 8.5 for the shuttle, 9 minutes for the Soyuz, the Russian Soyuz. And then you are there in the cabin, you are floating free. And at the beginning, it's disconcerting because it's such an unusual feeling. You can put your feet on the ceiling, the feet on the sidewall. There's no up, no down. But after a while, it's a wonderful feeling. That's one thing. And the other thing is the view. The view of the Earth is really spectacular, the view of the stars. We go around the Earth in about an hour and a half. And during the night, when the sun is below the horizon, you see the city lights moving rapidly. You see the stars moving rapidly in the sky. It's spectacular. So I was very impressed and touched by the beauty of the view and the wonderful feeling of absence of gravity. Well, it's to go through a very unusual experience. You know, people go to deserts, they go to high mountains. The adventure tourism is existing already on the Earth, and of course, this is going to be the ultimate adventure tourism to go into space. We look for unusual experiences. You know, the office is not too unusual, and walk in the forest is pretty nice, but it's not totally unusual. Go to high mountains, to deserts, to the poles, to Antarctica, is already out of the ordinary. Fly aerobatics in an airplane is out of the ordinary. Do scuba diving is out of the ordinary. And the next step is going to space. So I can understand that non-astronauts would like to experience that also.
So we figure there's three main ways that Google Street View can be useful for people who are traveling. So one of them is when you're dreaming. You want to know where it is you might want to go. So you could really look at some exotic destinations, see what Rome looks like on the ground, see what Bangkok looks like before you go. Then when you're dreaming, you're actually planning your trip. Then you can really look at the details of things. What does the front of my hotel look like? If I visit this restaurant, does it look like there's a car park that I can use? And then there's kind of the sharing aspect of it. So you could show people where you've been or where you're going by actually sending them a link to the exact spot and the things you saw. So I think the future of travel, especially as the internet and digital technology influences it, is that people will be able to travel to more places, but they'll get to enjoy them more and get more out of them and choose places better because of all the information that's out there. From imagery to sharing to being able to really understand deeply what's going on in the world, I think all that gives everyone a very powerful way to explore the world and participate in it. And so how Google is a part of that, well, Google's vision is to organize the whole world's information. And so by helping people communicate, helping them share, helping them explore and find things, including imagery, be it rich imagery or virtual reality imagery, all of those things together, I think are making people be able to interact with their world in a much richer way. And that's our goal.